today's video, I'm gonna show you guys how to make DIY cupcake bath bombs or just bath bombs in general without any complicated ingredients like cream of tartar, witch hazel, meringue powder and so on. I'm also gonna share tips and tricks to get the best professional bath bombs. So you might wanna stay tuned from the beginning till the end so that you do not miss out on anything.
Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you all are doing great. So in case you're new to my channel, hi, my name is Afreen and in today's video I'm gonna be showing you all how to make DIY bath bombs. They are great for gifting and really fun to make. So you might wanna call a bunch of friends and go crazy making these. You can be creative and try out whatever you want, but just keep in mind that bath bombs are pretty delicate guys, so you might want to focus on making it properly so that you do not activate the dry ingredients. And if you're not getting me right now, it's fine guys, I'm gonna be explaining it in detail and you'll understand it further. So without any further ado, let's see how to make DIY bath bombs. Before we get into the video guys, please make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon next to it so that you'll be notified whenever I upload a video.
So the first ingredient we require is baking soda. This is one of the main ingredients. Next, some citric acid. The mixture of citric acid and baking soda is what causes the fuzzing reaction when it comes in contact with water. If you do not have citric acid, a very good option is vitamin C powder, or you can also use apple cider vinegar or lemon juice in your liquid ingredients. Next, some Epsom salt, some cornstarch to bind all the ingredients together. For the liquid ingredients, we want to use some oil. I'm using castor oil and coconut oil. You can use whatever oil you want. Make sure whatever oil you're using is cold pressed and extremely good and hydrating for your skin. You can use argan oil, sweet almond oil, jojoba oil and so on. Next, some essential oil. I'm using a mixture of essential oils over here. I'm also using some lavender essential oil and some food colorings. You can also use soap dye if you wish. In a bowl, start by adding half a cup of baking soda. Next, add a quarter cup of Epsom salt, quarter cup of cornstarch, quarter cup of citric acid. Now you want to mix all of the dry ingredients well. In my previous video, I have shown you all how to make DIY scented bath salts guys, so you might want to check that out as well if you haven't already done that. I'll leave the link in the description or you can simply click on the I button above. Once it is well combined, keep it aside. For the liquid ingredients, start by adding 3 tablespoons of oil. I have added 2 of castor and 1 of coconut. Now I'm adding some essential oil. You also want to add a tablespoon of water. Now I know the question that arises is, won't the water activate the dry ingredients? But no guys, the quantity of the water is too less to activate the dry ingredients. Now I'm just adding color without water and mixing it. It doesn't mix properly. Now I'm adding 1 tablespoon of water. The water not only helps the color to mix nicely but also helps the cornstarch to combine all the ingredients. You just want to mix everything really well. In my upcoming video, I'm going to be showing you all DIY bath jellies inspired by Lush. So you might want to stay notified by subscribing to my channel and clicking on the bell icon next to it. Now you want to mix the liquid ingredients to the dry ingredients, but make sure you do it really quickly guys, and make sure you add little by little and not everything all together at once. You do not want to add all of the liquid guys, it should be enough to bind all the dry ingredients together. Now you want to fill up your mold completely and leave it to dry. I'm making cupcake bombs, so I'm gonna put it in a cupcake mold. Authentically, bath bombs are made in molds in the shape of a ball, which I'm gonna show you in my upcoming video about Lush bombs. You wanna leave the bath bomb to dry for 24 hours at room temperature or 2 hours in the refrigerator or freezer. It has been a day and a half, so I'm gonna be removing my bath bomb from its mold. If you are not using a silicone mold, make sure to tap the mold before removing the bath bomb. For my icing, I'm gonna be using an egg white along with some icing sugar mixed with a tablespoon of cornstarch. Icing sugar already has a percentage of cornstarch in it, but we are gonna add a little more so that the icing binds well. Beat the egg really well first and then make sure to fold in the icing sugar. Authentically, you add meringue powder or egg white powder, which is not easily available in India, so I'm using egg white. If you are a vegetarian, here's a really cool trick. You can use some shaving foam on the cupcake, guys. I've made various other bombs using different colors. I've also used cookie cutters, guys, so you can go crazy and be creative. Now it's time to make our sprinkles. You can use any sort of glitter or glitter powder. Now I'm gonna show you a really cool trick to make bath bomb sprinkles. All you wanna do is grab some Epsom salt or sugar and add some food color to it. Make sure to mix it really well, guys. And now you know that I'm obsessed with blue. Simply sprinkle it on the bath bombs and yeah, the icing has melted because of the heat from the lights, guys, but freeze it for half an hour and you'll be good to go. You can make the sprinkles of various colors and put it on the bath bombs, guys. I have gone ahead and added glitter later on. Now let's test our bath bombs. Wow, look how pretty it's turning out to be. Do try this at home, guys, and once you try it, please come back to my channel and comment down below and tell me if you liked it or not.
So that is it for this video, guys. I really hope you found this video helpful. In my upcoming videos, I'm gonna be showing you all how to make different kinds of bath bombs inspired by Lush. And also, I'm gonna be showing you all a tutorial on how to make DIY jelly soaps. These are really fun to make, guys. So you might wanna stay notified by clicking on the subscribe button and hitting the bell icon next to it. Also, if you found this video helpful, please make sure you like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel, guys. With that, it's a wrap. I'll see you all in my next video. Until then, bye-bye.